Hello everyone, how are you today? Welcome, this is Irish Donna Tarot and my name is Donna. So I'm happy to have all of you here. Thank you for joining me today. So let's jump in. Welcome to everyone who's new here. Let's see what the spirit messages are. Wish upon a star so your person sees you as a rock star, my friends. Aw, merry motive. You make them laugh. They like to have a good time with you. They feel joyful around you. They feel as though you are a star that shines very brightly. And we see the storyteller. So this person may tell tall tales. They may like to tell jokes. They may like to tell stories about their life. But it's charming. You know, they're an open book in many ways. So I feel as though you're going to hear a lot about this person. And this is a way of sort of filling in the gap when they don't know what else to say. We do see your person is coming into this reading with the Four of Swords. They've been through a bit of a rough patch. They might have been feeling under the weather. That can also mean, you know, healing their heart. But look at this energy, the Ace of Coins and the Four of Wands. This is a twin flame card, 11-11, but that is typically, that's the wedding tent. These are the bridesmaids. This is about stability. This is about making an offer to create stability in the relationship up to and including marriage, but it can be anywhere in the spectrum before that time also. We don't meet and immediately ask people to marry us, so we'll keep that in mind. But the Four of Wands is about someone who is in this Aries energy, taking action. This is a type of person that wants to be stable. They want to marry, they want to have a home, they would like to move in. They are very serious about the future with you, Libra. So when we look at the energy, this could be a new love reading or a fairly new love reading, maybe under 4 months, but take it as it resonates. A general reading is like a buffet table. Take what fits, leave the rest for everyone else. So we see that in their thoughts, Libra, that when they came into the relationship, they were just keeping their options open. They were trying to find you, Libra. We have the movement of cups. You inspired them to be very romantic. This person feels as though you, look at, we have the Knight of Cups twice. This person feels very fired up. Leo energy, Pisces energy, Scorpio energy. This person really has an intense vibe with you. They feel as though, you know, they could fall in love with you in a heartbeat. They feel very lucky to have met you. They feel with this infinity symbol, they feel that they've known you. You know, it's one of those times when I met this person and I felt so at home with them right away. And again, that really lends itself to this sort of merry motive, the joyfulness that they have. You know, they want this wishing upon a star, and you are that star. Their intentions with you are, excuse me, their heart space. This is thoughts, feelings, intentions, actions. In their heart space, they feel that, you know, they want to win. The Eight of Cups, they've left another relationship behind and they are headed in your direction. Again, this indicates to me that both of you were in the dating scene, 7 to the 8 of Cups. So whatever they were dabbling in over here, they left that situation to come towards you. The 10 of Cups, another marriage energy that's all about you. Look at this, marriage, possible marriage. So this person is very much focused on success. They're being very strategic. They put you on a pedestal. They think that you may be above their pay grade. As I always joke, my brother's friends used to tease him, oh, I don't know, she's not good enough for you. You know, sort of elbowing him like, I don't know. You know, I don't know what you have to bring to the table. All in good nature, of course. But we have the Five of Swords. This person has been treated badly in the past. They did leave something really hurtful behind, and it was the other person who was the problem. So you are dealing with someone who's very sincere and very real, somebody who's lived a portion of life and that's made them very realistic. Again, fire in their belly. Their intention is to have a solid, happy, joyful relationship with you based on emotional happiness. They see you as their rock star of love. they will be very discreet. A lot of times when this person isn't really, you know, being charming, it looks as though they're very observant. When we get the King of Cups energy and the High Priestess, that is Cancer Pisces energy. And they're very intuitive, they're very discreet, they're very nurturing also, and those are what they think that they have to bring to the table. But they want to introduce you to their friends, Libra. Look at that. They want to be in public spaces with you, having fun. They want to wine you, they want to dine you and take you out. In terms of their intentions for the long term, we have the energy of being very balanced, temperance energy. If this relationship has gone through, if it's longer than I think it is, you may have had a breakup and a makeup. So temperance, though, regardless of where you're at in this relationship, is the intention to keep everything balanced, happy, hardworking, moving forward, getting to know you, getting to know all about you, enjoying this new burst of love. And it looks as though you absolutely took them by storm. When they saw you as sexy, very dynamic. You know, some of you may have Libra in your birth chart somewhere. You have it on the seventh house, though, for sure. It does rule. You do have Aries on your seventh house. This is Aries energy. So they do see you as a dynamic partner, somebody who's always surprising them, someone who is that merry motive. Because when we get the Tower card and we get cards of stability, that means that it's a surprise, that all of this good vibe, this intentional effort to love you, is based on sort of being struck, you know, love struck, being struck by this lightning bolt of love towards you. The Tower card oftentimes means that the tower has to come down to build a foundation, but there are times, you know, 10%, 15% of the time, that when we get the tower, we get somebody that is awestruck, that it's like when you see somebody walking on the street and you basically stop, drop your groceries and go, oh my God, if I could just have that person. So when we look at their actions, they are definitely fighting for this relationship. They want to create a legacy with you. They're very ego-driven. They want to win, win, win. That energy is Leo energy. This is, you know, fighting for romance. They want the prize. They see you as a prize in romance. Not to objectify you, but because they want this beautiful merriment. You know, they see you as their rock star in love. They are moving away. They could be technically moving in the near future physically, but they're definitely moving towards you. Heart of Pentacles energy is Capricorn energy. They're very serious about nurturing this relationship, you know, creating a home for this relationship, a safe space for you. The Ace of Wands says that they have a very ardent desire and passion for you. The Seven of Cups and the Seven of Cups, when we see the Seven of Cups at the beginning of the reading, it looks as though, you know, you were dating and you met, and all of a sudden this person saw you and they want this relationship. Now, as we end the reading and we see the Seven of Cups, we see a person who is uncertain about what you want and how you will respond. So let's clarify that Seven of Cups for you. We'll clarify a couple of these cards to sort of understand them more deeply. The Seven of Cups at the end of this reading for you means that they have been heartbroken in the past. They do feel as though you are the only person that they want. Aw, very nice energy. Six of Cups. You're their heart. They feel very sweet about you. They feel as though you are the, you know, this beautiful energy of wishing upon a star. So they just don't know how you are responding to them. They don't really know where you're at in the spectrum of the relationship. Why do we have the Eight of Cups? What did they walk away from? Because it looks as though they walked away from somebody that they were dating when they met you. I do think that you might have met on a dating app. It's quite possible. It shows that this person was... I love this. This Hanged Man is different from any other deck. This Hanged Man looks like a cartoon character that's been bopped in the head and has stars. And of course, they're wishing upon a star for you. But when they saw you, when they met you, you know, the star card twice, they feel as though they have just been smitten. Smite me. They feel as though they have been awestruck. Okay. And when I got the card, this flipped out also as a clarifier for the Tower card. Ooh, when they saw you, there was no doubt what they want, how you present yourself in the world. They just see you as their happy place. The Sun is the happiest card in the deck. You know, the Temperance card is someone who likes to make relationship very sound, reliable, very safe, very balanced, and we get them rushing forward, you know, in terms of their intentions. So let's see what they are healing from. Let's see the Six of Swords energy. They would like to move closer to you. They're hoping that you allow it, but they don't know yet. The Seven of Swords energy, they were in a situation in which we have healing cards. So they came into the reading with needing to heal or mend their heart. We have the Six of Swords, them moving forward from somebody that lied to them. So it's very, you know, your person may be charming and you may think, are they telling me tall tales? But I don't see that. Libra, I see somebody who's very, very determined to win your heart, to present their best face, to win you over in a very honest, sweet, loving relationship. And they just don't know where you stand. So they see you as a high priestess. You're not saying much to them. You're staying very quiet. So that is what I have for you. Take care. Sending you love from Chicago since I'm back. Tell me where you're from, please. I would be delighted to know where around the globe you are watching this video from. Sending you love again. Hope to see you soon in another reading. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.